So if you haven't seen this before, it's a really simple thing to set up. I had vinegar in the bottom of the bottle and bicarbonate of soda in the balloon. And when you mix them by tipping it in, they react to form carbon dioxide, and that's what's inflated the balloon. It's a really fun way to blow up a balloon, but we can use this really simple reaction to do a slightly longer activity that gets the children really thinking about science. This is an activity that I like to call fizzy cubes. I've just got an ice cube tray and I've put bicarbonate of soda in half the tray, roughly similar amounts in each cube. And in the other half, I've put in edible ingredients from around the kitchen. So I've got soy sauce, honey, lime juice and apple juice, orange juice and vinegar. Now, the activity itself is really simple. We're just going to spoon the bicarbonate of soda into each ingredient and look really closely at what happens. What's it doing?
Fizzing
up. What's coming out?
Bubbles.
This activity is all about observing what happens when you mix two things together. So it's a good idea to ask questions to make sure children notice the different behaviours when the bicarbonate of soda is added to the different ingredients.
Is that one fizzing more or less than the soy sauce?
More.
Do you think?
Oh, it's nearly coming out!
The fizzing is a result of a chemical reaction. In simple terms, this is when two things come together to make something new. It's useful to point out that the new thing being produced in this reaction is a gas, carbon dioxide, which is what makes the fizz, or tiny bubbles.
Is it still doing it? As you add more of the light, is it still fizzing up?
The amount of fizzing depends on how acidic the other ingredient is. The bicarbonate of soda doesn't react with ingredients which are not acidic. You can use this activity to get into the balloon inflation by asking whether making gas like this could be useful, and then suggest inflating a balloon using the best reaction.
It's not generally a good idea to eat your scientific experiments.
It's yummy!
If we put some powder in and then some vinegar, and we mix them in the bottle and put the balloon on top,
I found that blowing up the balloon once before the experiment to pre-stretch it really helps, as does making a paper funnel to get the powder into the balloon.
Okay, how many spoons should we put in?
Four.
Why four?
If you've got time, and don't mind the mess, you can investigate how much of the ingredients are needed to blow up the balloon well.
Go down.
That's going down in the grid.
I use about 8 teaspoons of bicarbonate and fill the bottle about a third of the way up with vinegar to make sure the balloon inflates properly.
Perfect. That's it.
No.
So what's it filled with now?
Air.
Do you think it's the same as the air that we breathe?
No.
Why not?
Because it's made out of this, and air that we breathe isn't made out of this.
Ah, very good, yeah. Now, I know that we've looked at chemical reactions. Viola's a bit too young for that, but it doesn't really matter. What we've both got out of it is that we were looking closely at what happened during the reactions and had a good time doing it too.
I can smell the vinegar.
Oh!
Cool. I knew it was going to change.